Welcome back to my channel. Happy Friday. Today I thought I would share with you what I've done to my cousin for the month of January. I'm in a slightly different location. I'm still in the living room, but I am using our TV tray. I also have a light source on over there, as well as the ceiling fan behind me. I have the heater on. It's kind of chilly outside, and I have Bruce and Kit Kat on the couch. They're both asleep, and so I'm trying to keep us all warm. It's about 60 inside the house right now. So let me insert a clip of them napping on the couch. Here is my cousin. It is still relatively thin, which I'm okay with. This is December. January. And I still haven't decorated for February yet. I did mark down the days that we're gonna have street cleaning outside. I still have to put down the sticker for Bruce's vet appointment, as well as his medication, which he received yesterday, his flea medication. And that was him hopping off the couch. Hopefully he won't play too much in the background, because I know that can be a little bit loud. Now let's go to the weekly layout. So this is the first week of January. I am not shy about using the washi tape or stickers. And if I have packages, I'll put it over here. And just to show you a different look, my A5 Hun is in here. This is the leather cover. And I just wanted to show you a functional, no stickers layout that I've been using. So this is something that I have with me, beside me, every single day as I'm working. And I do my task list. I initially had said I didn't want to use washi tape, but I have a lot of washi tape. And so I decided just to put a little bit down, not too much, because I don't want to thicken this at all. This is my writer's notebook. And then when I am decorating this one and filling this out, I can pull this guy out, refer to this, and then decorate in here. This is the second week. Third week. This was last week. And as you can see, the packages are there. And then this is this week. Today's Friday. The Pineapple Express came through yesterday, and I think it's gonna come again on Sunday. And then this is washi tape that I think I'm pretty sure I purchased this from Walt Disney World in 2017. And this is another reason why I'm trying to use up all my washi tape. This washi tape, I love it because it's little pandas, kind of dressed up in little Chinese outfits. And it was really hard trying to use this washi tape because it kept ripping, did not want to unroll. So I decided to go ahead and just use it up. So you don't see it here, but in my A5 Hun, I think I used the rest of it in there. So that's what this looks like. And I think Bruce will start playing with his toys. This is the turning the page layout. I haven't done anything here because I don't know what I want to do with it yet. Chances are I'm just going to end up taping down photos, images that I like from magazines, which is what I did last year. This is the monthly, for the month, blank page, right? So the January blank page, and I decided to use it as my thinking about page. Each block and the stickers, the sticker box is from Happy Planner. I decided to put down what I was thinking of for the month of January, and I did this, I think, last weekend. So I've been thinking about my mom, who's still in a facility. She hasn't been able to go home. Bruce has had a lot of health issues that we've been dealing with since about mid-December. And then 2024, new year, new start, Gudetama, my garden. I've been thinking about that. I am, the gopher back there is still, he's still back there, and I really want a garden, but I don't know if he's gonna interrupt my gardening. And then my books that I really want to finish this year. This is the first page. So this is what I did, continuing with the watercolor, because I was curious to see how the pages would absorb the water and how it would affect it. There's Kit Kat. There's his little paw. Here's Bruce and Kit Kat. Now the crinkling from this, if you can sort of see it on the page, came from this. I forgot to slide the pencil board underneath it. And so when I watercolored this, it sort of, the dampness sort of went through the other pages. Magazine cutout. And I do this when I don't have anything that I want to draw, photos to put down. I don't have any, there's nothing about the day that I want to remember. I would just put down images that I cut out from magazines that I like. My mom's Cymbidium. There's Bruce. On the 11th of January, I discovered that a fruit striped gum was going to be discontinued. This was something that my mom used to buy us when we were kids. And so I decided to draw it. Still haven't colored it in. I still haven't. It's still in pencil. I should probably go over it with a black pen or something. These are Weeble Wobbles. So this, I don't know if you can see it, but I still have my pencil marks down. And I just went over it with a nobly black pen. This is the tip-in. I did a video, I think last week, of how I tip in photos into my Hobonichi Cousin using the Hobonichi paper. And so this is what it looks like. Filled in a little bit. This is my niece and nephew. There's Bruce. Bruce enjoying the sun through the front window. And these are sand dollars. A limpet and a barnacle. This is a magazine cutout that I decided to use as a portrait. Another magazine cutout. I'm going to be giving some of my books to my mother-in-law. My husband's going to be going on his fishing trip, I think in April or May. And she agreed to take some of the books that I have in my bookshelf that I'm no longer reading, which will clear up space in what I call my library. And so now I'm kind of thinking, once I get rid of those books, it's going to free up a lot of space. I can put things from the floor into my bookcases. And I'm debating if I want to paint the walls, what I want to do. So that's why I was glad I cut this out a few months ago, and now I have a use for it. This is supposed to be a watercolor sketch of some tacos that we bought after grocery shopping on a Sunday. I'm sorry about that. I have the camera tied into a stack of stuff. So that's why every time Bruce gets off the couch, the floor vibrates a little bit. So this is the day that Hobonichi did their spring release, showing us, giving us our preview. I really like these covers. I like the image. This is that blank notebook. Really, really like it. I personally can't justify buying it right now. So what I'm going to do is I decided to draw it in onto my pages. I'm going to eventually have to watercolor it, but I drew it in. And I'm going to wait till September, checking out the new releases for 2025 at that time. And if these are still available to purchase, I will pick it up then. So far so good on my no spend. No spend, no buy. On Wednesday the 24th, this is when we took Bruce to his vet appointment. My normal vet was sick, another vet came in. So this is a selfie of myself and my husband, as well as Bruce. Here's another magazine cutout. This is another magazine cutout. Again, thinking about spring and the things that I want to plant. On this page, this is a picture of my Valencia orange tree. I think it's about 6 feet tall, but it has a lot of oranges on there, which I'm pretty happy about. Papaya seeds. I don't know if you can see the little seedlings. It took about, I think, a month for them to sprout, but I was really happy with that. Here's a picture of some dim sum and what I thought of it. This is Jackie. She is a bald eagle in Big Bear. She laid her second egg, and so I decided to sketch that in and talk a little bit about it. They have a YouTube channel, which I will link down below, as well as there is a Facebook group too. I will link that down below. But we had a Pineapple Express come through yesterday, and I bring that up only because, okay, wait a minute. Okay, so before I go there, this is a comparison of eggs, which I thought was really interesting from the Hanover Bald Eagle blog. This is the size of a bald eagle. Here is the size of a chicken egg, and then a robin egg. So you can see how big an eagle's egg is, a bald eagle. Now Jackie laid her third egg on January 31. And so that's what I was trying to draw. So that's her body right there. And she laid it the night before the Pineapple Express arrived here in Southern California. And the Pineapple Express is just a really cold, rainy, strong storm that is passing through. So it passed through, it started raining January 31 into February 1st. So that's what this picture is. So up in Big Bear, it snowed while it rained down here. So this is not colored in yet, but there is snow here. This is her. It's called pancaking, pancake, I-N-G, where she's laying on top of her eggs and she's keeping her eggs warm, insulated from the snow. So if you are curious to see what this looks like right now, because there's still snow on the nest, I'm staring at the screen on my laptop as I am filming this. Shadow, which is her mate, is currently sitting in the nest bowl doing this. But this is Jackie. She is bigger than Shadow. I can't tell them apart when the snow is not there. I can only tell them apart right now because there's snow on the nest. When she pancakes, she is bigger. So she takes up a lot more. And then again, the snow fell, so it left this imprint like a snow angel. So when she gets up and he sits on top and starts incubating, there will be space around where she had left her snow angel, if that makes sense. So right now he's on the nest and you can see a lot of space between him and the snow pile. I am not affiliated with them. I am not endorsed, you know, none of that stuff. I just enjoy watching their videos, the live feeds. I personally, though, will stop watching once the eggs hatch, because then they start bringing in live prey, live fish, you know, food to feed their babies. And for me, because I'm sort of, it's not easy for me to watch. So I don't watch that part of it. I will from time to time go in and peek to look at them when they're not eating, just to see the little fuzzy babies. But other than that, I will not watch consistently. But so this is Jackie, and hopefully I'll get this colored in so you can see it. Here is my February month page. On here, I will probably do something similar that I did right here. So I have a lot of Happy Planner boxes that I can put down here and then do another thinking about of what I'm thinking about for the month of February. And if I do something like this again for February, I probably will decorate this, do this probably closer towards the end of the month, because then I would have known what I've been thinking about for the month of February. So if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the pin videos of my cousin. Bye!